Now, this lecture on oncology pharmacy services, the duration of attachment of PRP is 2 weeks. It includes knowledge of aseptic techniques, principles of cytotoxic cabinet and clean room design, types of protective gowning procedure, room differential pressure, calculation, solubility and compatibility problems, cytotoxic spill procedure, maintenance of cytotoxic safety cabinet, quality assurance test of aseptic fit, safe handling of cytotoxic drugs, and disposal of cytotoxic waste. It also includes ability to read and comprehend patient case notes, ability to assess patient suitability for chemotherapy and the appropriate dosage form, ability to discuss with prescriber, calculation and worksheet, reconstitution, patient monitoring and counseling in the ward. Oncology pharmacy services have the training period of 2 weeks, and in which the name of preceptor must be mentioned, and there are different tasks for PRP, which include principles of cytotoxic cabinet and clean room design, maintenance of cytotoxic cabinet and clean room, which contains cleaning of cytotoxic cabinet and clean room, and also quality assurance. Principles of aseptic techniques also included in the task, which have hand washing, gowning, gloving, removing protective clothing, withdrawal of cytotoxic drug solution from ampoule, adding diluent to an ampoule containing cytotoxic drug in powder form, adding of drug solution from ampoule to infusion bottle, adding diluent to the vial containing cytotoxic drug in powder form, withdrawing drug solution from vial, manipulation techniques, which include transfer from bag or bottle to syringe, transfer from vial to bag or bottle, transfer from ampoule to vial. Also included safe handling of cytotoxic drugs, which have personal protective equipment, PPE, disposal of cytotoxic waste, spill management, health monitoring, transportation and storage, and in last, management of extravagance. So that these tasks have briefing, which included yes or no. Now the section 1, ability to assess patient suitability for chemotherapy and the appropriate dosage form. Screening of chemotherapy request and communication with the prescriber. The PRP must attend minimum 10 cases. So the week 1 followed by a chart, which included date, patient RN, number of intervention, type of intervention, communication with prescriber, status of PRP, name and signature of preceptor. Type of interventions included incomplete prescriptions, which follows frequency, duration, signature and CHOP, and also countersign. Inappropriate dosage form, which included medicine, duration, dose and frequency. Inappropriate prescriptions like spelling, wrong identification, polypharmacy, interaction, contraindication. Others, which included not in the hospital drug formulary, and its legally available or its availability. So that the status of PRP also included as observer, assistant or performer. Then this chart followed by in the same manner in week 2. So the same pattern has been followed in week 2. Now, section 2 include preparation of worksheet, calculation and worksheet, minimum 10 cases. Worksheet included label and counter checking. There is also a chart which indicate date, patient, name of the cytotoxic drug in the preparation, status of PRP, name and signature of preceptor. This also followed in the same pattern in week 2. So there is the chart for week 2. Now the section 3 includes the reconstitution of at least 10 patients, so that this included date, patient RN, number of preparation, name of drug, status of PRP, name and signature of receptor, and total number of preparation. So that is followed by the same manner in week 2. So there is the chart for week 2. Now the section 4 included patient monitoring, counseling, at least 5 cases. Monitoring and counseling also mentioned separately in the chart. The chart include date, patient RN, case monitoring, counseling, status of PRP, name and signature of receptor. The same manner followed in week 2. So there is the same method for week 2. Now on assessment. Now on move towards section 5, assessment on knowledge. There are different tasks which include principle of cytotoxic cabinet and clean room, design, maintenance of cytotoxic cabinet and clean room, which include cleaning of cytotoxic cabinet and clean room, quality assurance. Principles of aseptic techniques include hand washing, gowning, gloving, etc. Principle of aseptic techniques also include transfer from bag or bottle to syringe, transfer from vial to bag or bottle, transfer from ampule to vial. Also have a task of safe handling of cytotoxic drugs, personal protective equipment which include disposal of cytotoxic waste, spill management, health monitoring, transportation and storage. Also included principles of aseptic technique validation and principles of extravagance management. Grade of performance also mentioned in this assessment and comments by the preceptor. Now section 6, competent assessment. It has task ability to assess patient suitability for chemotherapy and appropriate dosage form, preparation of worksheet, reconstitution, patient monitoring and counseling, assessment on knowledge. There are level of performance which include level 1, 2, 3, 4 and not available. Also comments from the preceptor or a chief pharmacist. Section 7 includes general comment on attitude which followed by preceptor's name and signature. Note that if the service is not available in the hospital, the principal preceptor or head of pharmacist in the hospital has right to assist the assessment and abilities of a PRP. The percentage mark should not less than 60% for every unit or services. Now there are summary of performance, which has activity, assessment of knowledge, ability to assess patient suitability for chemotherapy and the appropriate dosage form, calculation and worksheet, reconstitution, patient monitoring and counseling. Grade of performance and the performance multiplied by 100% divided by 40. So the percentage of the performance has been concluded. Comments from the preceptors and preceptor's name and signature. That is all for oncology pharmacy.